Hello and welcome. This video is part of a series, just a little bit of a talk about what we've been working on. I've been working with a Motorola G4 Play, which a buddy of mine bought relatively cheap online. I think he paid like $100 for it. He bought it, you know, for his business. We're working on a project. We're going to be hooking this to a drone to get some data as it flies around, which phones are great little devices for that. They're cheap. They got the battery in them. They got the GPS. They got all these antennas and stuff in them. But what we've been doing so far is we unlocked the bootloader. We installed a custom recovery, a custom ROM, put in the OpenG apps, which are your Google apps for the mod. But I want to talk about how you can get that stuff on there. So mainly the mods and the apps. So when we put Lineage OS on here, we did what was called a side load. When I did the OpenG apps video, we pushed it over and then copied it. Really, both could be pushed over and both could be side loaded. What is the difference? So pushing, using ADB push command, is basically through USB, or you can also, well, you can do it through network, but not through the recovery, because there's no network in the recovery that I'm aware of. I'm sure it's possible, though. Basically, you hook a USB to this, ADB push the file on your computer and where you want it to go on the phone, and it copies it over. It's the same as drag and drop into an SD card. You just use an ADB. In fact, you could have just drag and drop. Once you hook up through USB, you should be able to drag and drop it over to the SD card or internal storage on the phone. So basically, you're taking the zip file of Lineage OS or of the OpenG apps or whatever other files you're going to install, and you're copying into the phone, and then you go into the phone and you choose install and choose that zip file, and it will take those files and install them to the proper partitions, because there's instructions in those zip files for the program on how to do that. As I also mentioned, there's also information in those files, inside the zip files, that check to make sure you're installing them on the proper phone with the proper version of Android, so that you don't mess up your phone by putting OpenG apps for Android 4.0 on Android 8.0 phone. And if you try to put a Lineage OS mod or some other mod on a phone that it's not designed for, it will tell you that it's not the phone by checking the code name for that phone and other stuff that's on the phone. And you can try to trick it and force it. It's usually a bad idea. There's a reason it does that. Getting back to the point of this video, so we can copy the files over and click install, or we can sideload. Basically, what sideloading is we're taking the file, it's on our computer, and am I in focus? It looks like I am now. We're pushing it through USB to the phone, but it's not putting that file on the internal storage or an SD card or any type of flash storage. Basically, I believe it's just sitting in RAM. So basically, it copies the zip file over to the phone RAM, and then it unzips and puts it where it belongs. What are the benefits of one over the other? So, I like sideloading. I've got it on my computer, I copy it over, it's installed or installed, and I don't have that zip file on the phone anymore taking up space. I usually back it up someplace else. I don't need it on the phone. That's why I like sideloading. The nice thing about pushing it to the phone is that it's always on there. So if I have the Lineage OS and the OpenG apps zip files on the internal storage, as long as I don't wipe out the internal storage, I can go into recovery and I can reflash those images and those applications anytime I want without hooking to my computer. That's the benefit of it, but then they're taking up space on your device. Again, I just like to keep my system clean, so I don't push that stuff to the phone. I prefer to sideload. But basically, that's the only difference, is whether it's the zip file still on the phone when you're done or not. Sideloading pushes it to RAM, installs it when it needs to be installed, and then it's gone on reboot. Pushing it puts it on the storage of the phone or the SD card. You can also, you know, like I said in previous videos, get yourself an OTG cable, hook it up to your phone, hook up a flash drive. If the zip files are on that flash drive, you can install them that way. Basically, you know, as long as they're on the phone, whether they're in RAM or they're on a flash memory on the phone, so internal, external memory, it doesn't matter. The recovery can find it. So that's it. I just wanted to go over that in case I didn't explain it well in the previous videos, because I did one way and one the other, and you can do both either way. So I do thank you for watching, and as always, I hope that you have a great day.